Hello and welcome to another lesson of the basic SEO course. In the previous lesson, we looked at SEO strategies and priorities. Now let's look at how search engines display the results and talk about the SERP. We'll examine in detail what a SERP is and how organic results are presented by search engines like Google. It's going to be interesting. So off we go. After you type a query, a search engine analyzes it, decides what you're looking for, finds the best results, ranks them, and presents them to you. At that point, what you see on the screen is the search engine results page, aka SERP. SERP is a page of recommended content that a search engine generates based on a user's query. As you can see, the SERP is a list of blue links to pages that match the subject of the query. But there may also be other additional elements on the page: images, videos, a city map, advertisements, featured snippets, a knowledge graph, and so on and so on. We'll talk about all of these in detail today and in the next lesson. We've gone over the structure and concept of the SERP. Now let's find out more about the organic results and their features. The main thing you need to remember: free organic search results have nothing to do with advertising. It's the search engine that selects the web pages and determines their position in the list. Google takes into account page relevance, how well its content matches the search query, and its own evaluation of quality and appropriateness for deciding which page gets which position in the SERP. The majority of the results in a search engine results page are organic and not advertising. Google presents a list of sites it recommends to its users with no commercial gain for Google in the form of what I call blue links, anything from 5 or 6 to 10 per page. Each page in the organic results is represented by a small block called a snippet, consisting of a blue link to the page, a header, and a short description. In some cases, we may see what is called a rich snippet, which displays supplementary information in addition to the brief summary. For example, a snippet may contain site links that help users quickly navigate to important sections of a website, such as in this example, or company ratings according to user reviews, such as here. It can also be a snippet with a short series of related questions. You'll see a lot of these special rich snippets when Googling things like products, recipes, books, films, learning courses, and job openings. Now let's take a look at pay-per-click and Google Ads. These are ads, contextual ads, that appear in the SERP. As a rule, we see them on commercial search queries that relate to a product or service. They look similar to the blue links in organic. They have a title, a description, and the URL of the page. They can be distinguished from regular results by the ad mark. Contextual ads appear above and below the list of organic search results. Google has a special service called Google Ads for setting up ad campaigns. For a contextual advertisement from Google Ads to appear in the SERP, appropriate keywords have to be specified by the advertiser in the settings. Contextual advertising functions on the principle of pay-per-click, PPC. That is, the advertiser pays for each user who clicks through to the site. In addition to contextual text ads, contextual shopping ads may appear in search results too. They're displayed as picture blocks below the query bar or to the right of search results. The SERP itself consists of different search categories or verticals in Google speak. You can see them at the very top, right below the search bar. The first and main section is All. Here we see a list of 8 or 9 pages presented as blue links, often alongside results from other search categories on the SERP. I'll discuss those rich elements from other categories or verticals in detail in the next lesson. The other tabs can change their position in the navigation menu or hide behind the More button depending on the request. Google supports searching by images, videos, news, maps, flights, finance, books, and shopping. Let's take a closer look at them. Click on the Video tab and you'll only see videos. Click on the Images tab and you'll only see images. News shows only relevant, mostly recent articles on the subject. Clicking on the Maps section will take you straight to Google Maps. Here, you are in travel mode, where you can find a route to your destination, save the location to favorites, and zoom in on the map. By the way, here you can also view the shops, establishments, hotels, hospitals, and other locations in your or any other area. For example, we typed in Cafe Downtown Seattle and got all the cafes in the neighborhood marked on the map. Note that only 20 results appear on the map. You can click on each location and see information about it: website, opening hours, phone number, rating, and customer reviews. The next section is shopping. Here, Google can display products with their prices, ratings, and other characteristics depending on the query. Now, shopping, very commercial and lucrative for Google. Here you see products that are relevant to your search query and have filters on the left where you can sort the results, in this case, set the price range, select screen resolutions, different functions, and so on and so forth. Obviously, the filters offered depend on the product. You can click on one of the products and you'll be taken to the retailer's site with more detailed information and the possibility to purchase from them. Moving on, finance. Here you can see the relevant information Google has about stocks, exchange-traded funds, and other assets. There's also a new stock statistics, market trends, and much more. In the Books tab, you'll see Google Books, which is an owned Google database for books and authors. When you click on any of the books, you'll be directed to the dedicated Google site, where you can see all the details about the book and also look through a section of the book. And you'll often be given the option to buy its electronic version. It's basically a massive library come bookstore. And the last section is flights. Clicking on that tab takes you to a special Google service where you can view flights, select a date and destination, see offers from an airline, or go to its website to book. Basically, everything you can do at the most popular airline aggregators. So that's it for the verticals at the top of Google search results. Let's move on. Whatever your query is, you'll almost always find a related queries box at the bottom of the search results. Here, you'll find query variations that are related to the ones that the users make. Basically, it's a list of suggestions. The search engine shows you how else you might want to search for and around this information. Google is giving you the opportunity to continue your search without typing in another query by simply clicking on one of the options. And then, almost at the bottom of the SERP, has an option to go to beyond page one to other results pages. Finally, right at the bottom, you'll find the footer block. It shows your location. That might seem unhelpful since you know where you are. But remember that to a large extent, the results Google shows you are dependent on your geolocation. That means the results are more relevant for you as a user, which is something that you should take into consideration as a marketer in your SEO strategy. Clicking on the Help tab will take you to the Google Search Help Center, where you can find answers to questions about using Google Search as a user. And by clicking on the Privacy and Terms of Use sections, you'll learn everything about the data Google collects and why. Both this and the Help section I just mentioned are packed with helpful information that's important for you to use as a Google user. But if you also read it with your marketer's hat on, it will give you an insight into Google's approach to ranking. This could have been the end of our lesson, but we can't leave mobile search results aside. We use phones a great deal. As at 2021, on Google, we use mobile phones more than we use desktop computers, especially when we're not at work. Because we use phones more than we use computers, Google is focusing on mobile, and they increasingly formulate all their results according to our mobile queries. In short, Google is organizing its results on a mobile-first basis and gives preference to mobile-friendly sites when ranking. Mobile search results have their own particularities. Let's take a look at them. The mobile SERP is different in terms of website rankings. When Googling the same query, you'll get different results on a phone than on your computer. Try it for yourself, it's mind-blowing. The mobile version has no pagination. While the desktop version allows you to immediately go from the first to the fifth page of the results, on a phone, there is only the More Results button, clicking on which will take you to the next page. Also, in the mobile results, fav icons are displayed at the top of the snippet along with the name of the resource and the link. And in the snippet itself, you often see the main picture of the page or a video. Apps are a special case. When searching for a term that is app relevant on a mobile device, you can see a box for installing an app on the phone. Then the mobile version is also easy to use, voice activated. All you have to do is press the microphone and speak your search query. In addition to the standard search, there are several other tabs. Under the Discover tab, you'll see a weather forecast for your region and various breaking news. The Snapshot section features a list of things to do, such as a reminder for a flight and the collections section will show you the items you've saved, pages, locations on the map, images, and more. That's a wonderfully clear indication as to where Google's going with search and where SEO needs to adapt in the years to come. It's attempting to predict the search queries, what we will want to do next, and help us towards our ultimate goal preemptively. Now, that completes the lesson. I hope you've garnered lots of useful information. In the next lesson, I'll continue on the topic of search engine results and review the rich elements in Google's SERP, the so-called SERP features. I'll see you in the next lessons. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon.